Sorry. Also, you can follow us every Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. Mountain Time. We're going to go ahead and worship the Lord for a few moments. We're going to listen to some Christmas music by Kim Walker. But as you're coming on, go ahead and invite your friends, invite your family.
Amen.
And let us just know what God's done for you this morning.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Just worship the Lord for a few moments.
Yes, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Praise your name, Father God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
All is calm.
Yes, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah, Jesus. Don't forget to share with your friends where they can hear the message today. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. We praise you this morning, Father. Yes, Lord. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Holy,
hallelujah, Jesus.
Shepherds quail.
Yes, they do. Time of year, Melissa. It really is. Celebrating the birth of our Lord. You know, those in the Old Testament, they watched and waited and waited and watched for his birth. And we now, in the New Testament and the present day church, we celebrate his birth.
That's right.
He's here. Amen.
Right. He's come already.
Hallelujah. He has come.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. And we need to continue to pray for those that do not have the revelation that he's come. There's still many today that are waiting for him to be born. They are.
Yes.
And we know that he already has been born. He has already come. So we're so thankful this morning that we know him. Amen.
That's
and that he is just no longer a little baby lying in a manger. But he's the Lord of Lord, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Melissa. Hallelujah.
That's
and you know, here in our home, we have many, many nativity scenes. But that doesn't mean that we worship that tiny baby, you know, and still think that he's this tiny baby. He is the
King of Kings
and Lord of Lords. Amen. And that's who we worship.
That's right.
The Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Prophet Renee, God bless you.
Good morning.
God bless you, Brother David. We're glad to have you this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Praise you, Father. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. We have our little snowman mugs this morning. Melissa and I. Melissa, hold your snowman mug up. Turn it around the other way. Aren't these beautiful?
Yeah.
Yeah.
As anybody knows, Prophetess, she loves snowmen.
I collect snowmen. Amen.
Amen.
I really do. And this was a gift from Pastor Britt to Apostle and me a few years back.
Yep. Thank God they don't come alive every night.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Well, once again, thank you for joining us live
here this
Thursday morning. We're glad to see you, Brother David and Prophetess Renee. Whoever's going to come on later on.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Today we're going to be talking about how do you see?
Yeah.
Or I guess, do you see correctly?
Mm-hmm.
Might be another way you could put this message.
Yes, do you see correctly? I like that.
And what we're going to really talk about, in which we all know the both stories, we're going to talk about the birth of Jesus again as the holiday season is upon us. We're going to talk about how Matthew saw the birth of Jesus and how Luke saw the birth of Jesus.
Yes.
How they're two different stories, but yet it's still the birth of our Savior.
Mm-hmm. And they need to get their Bible out if they want to follow along with us, because we're going to be reading a lot of scripture this morning, Melissa.
We are.
Yeah.
We're going to first start off with reading, like I said, we're going to be talking about Matthew and Luke, how they both told the story of Jesus' birth.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? Neither one contradicted the other.
Let's get that straight.
You know, one just had different version than the other, mm-hmm. but they're both true.
Mm-hmm.
They're both true.
Mm-hmm. That sort of reminds me, Melissa, of the written word and Rhema word.
Right. That's true.
Yeah, they're both from God, and one don't contradict the mm-hmm. other. When we get a Rhema word, if someone's giving you a word, a prophetic mm-hmm. word, and it contradicts the word of Christ, that is not of God.
That's right. Try the Spirit. Try the word.
Yes. Amen.
That's right. The beginning scripture, which, like I said, we're going to read a lot of scripture. The first one we're going to read is actually Matthew 1:18, and mm-hmm. it says, "This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother, Mary, was pledged to be married to Joseph,
mm-hmm.
but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit."
Wow.
And we're first going to talk about how Matthew told the story of the birth of Christ. If you read the whole chapter of Matthew, the first chapter actually goes into the genealogy of Christ's lineage.
Yes.
You know,
uh-huh.
it goes from beginning to up to him.
That's right.
That's how Matthew starts off
mm-hmm.
with the
mm-hmm.
with the chapter. But if you go on to read Matthew 1, 18 through 25, and we're going to read each verse, and we're going to talk about each verse.
Yes.
So
follow along with us in your Bible.
That's
Amen.
Right. And it's funny because, when I came back to the Lord, I was so thirsty, and I just wanted to read everything. I wanted to know everything. And I read, when I started reading the New Testament, I didn't realize, and I know I probably did as a young kid, but, I didn't read the Word for many years, 25 years or so. And I forgot, but when I read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and even John, I didn't realize how it was like the same story, but from a different version.
Right.
And it was like, wow, I don't remember that, but mm-hmm. I thought that was just pretty neat.
Yes. Uh-huh. Well, Melissa, that's sort of like if you see a car accident.
Right.
And that's the reason they like to have many different
witnesses
mm-hmm. because one saw something that the other didn't
mm-hmm.
see, or and so mm-hmm. that's what we're talking about this
that's
morning.
Right.
How are we seeing?
Right.
Some see it one way and some see mm-hmm. it another.
But are we seeing it correctly?
Uh-huh, and mm-hmm. are we seeing it correctly?
That's
true. That's what we need to remember too, mm-hmm.
So we're going to go ahead and read. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about.
Mm-hmm.
His mother, Mary, was pledged to be married to Joseph. But before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It goes on to say, because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. So
mm-hmm.
it says here that Joseph actually knew the law.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure he studied the Old Testament. He knew that there was going to be a Savior born. It was going to become a virgin. But I guess he didn't realize this was the woman,
mm-hmm. Well, that news would be shocking to anyone.
Right, exactly. Here, how can you even be worthy of being involved in this? Uh-huh. You know, that might be what, too. I'm not worthy to be involved in this.
And not only that, but Joseph had to wonder or ponder in his heart if Mary had been unfaithful to him.
Right. You know how it crossed his mind.
He's human. Yeah, he was human. Yes, right. He was human.
That's right. He was human.
The Bible don't say that.
Right.
But, you know, as humans, we know that there is no such thing as a virgin birth.
That's right.
You know, it has to be a spiritual thing.
That's right, spiritual thing.
And you have to be really spiritual to believe that back in that day.
Right.
Because you could lose your life.
That's right. That's true. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It goes on to say in verse 20, it says, but after he had considered this.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, he's thinking about, okay, well, she's pregnant. What am I going to do?
Yeah.
He fell asleep because it says an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream.
Wow.
And said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife.
Yes.
Because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
What a wake-up call, huh?
Mm-hmm.
It goes on to say, she will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. Because he will save his people from their sins.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
And I don't even know if they even knew exactly what all that meant.
No, I'm sure they didn't.
You know, and all this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, we just read a minute ago that Joseph was a man of the law, so he knew what the prophets had prophesied.
Yes, yes.
And it says the virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel.
Yes.
Which means God with us. Mm-hmm. Once again, I don't think they realized exactly what was taking place, but they were willing to be used of God.
And Melissa, I love that, how the Lord sent an angel, you know, to speak to him and give him direction.
That's right.
And the Lord still is sending the angels today on our behalf, you know, to war for us. And also he sends the angels to give us direction, which way to go, what to do and what not to do.
That's right. That's right. And it says when Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate the marriage until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus.
Yes.
So we see here, you know, Matthew was talking about, you know, how Joseph was thinking, like we said, how he's thinking about divorcing her.
Right.
Because he didn't want to disgrace her, because he was a man of honor and integrity. He was. But it doesn't say that Mary, and according to Matthew, his version, it doesn't say that Mary told him how angel came to her. It doesn't say that.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't say that she told him that she was carrying the Messiah. It doesn't say that, it doesn't go into detail at all about the conversation between Mary and Joseph.
Right. That would have been a hard thing to try to convince somebody of. That's the reason the Lord sent the angel.
That's right.
You know.
That's right.
And Joseph knew without a doubt
that
God was speaking directly to him through the angel.
That's right.
And told him not to be afraid to take Mary home as your wife.
That's
See,
right.
probably, I mean, like we just said that, you know, they were human, just
That's
like
right.
you and I are. And Mary probably would not have been able to convince Joseph that, you know, what she had witnessed. Maybe she could have, I don't know.
Right.
But I believe that's the reason the Lord himself, see, God will speak to us himself. You know, we also know that he does speak to us through others, but he also does give us dreams and visions and speak to us. And so I want to say to you that are watching this morning, you know, be very sensitive to the Spirit at this time and make sure, you know, you consider your dreams. If you have dreams, pray about dreams and pray about them and ask God, Lord, is this of you? Are you trying to speak to me? Because God does still give prophetic dreams and visions today.
Mm-hmm.
Today, that's one of the ways that God does speak to us is through dreams.
That's right.
Yes, amen.
Well, you're right, prophets. He does many times through us. He's spoke through dreams. But too, I was thinking about how it says, you know, how he had a mind
To divorce her.
To divorce her. then it said, you know, he considered, because he first was like, I was going to divorce her, I'm going to break up with her, pretty much is what he's saying, because he or she is pregnant. But then he started thinking, well, is that the right thing? And as he was thinking about that, he fell asleep. So he's already starting to have second thoughts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But he needed God to send his angel to get him on the right track.
That's right.
And that's what happened.
Thank you, Lord.
Got him on the right track.
It took a supernatural act of God.
That's right.
To convince Joseph.
Yeah. Well, this was a big one.
Yes.
Especially in that day, whoever heard of a virgin? Mm-hmm. Like I said, we all knew it was prophesied, but now you're telling me she's the one.
Yeah.
You're telling me you're the one? You know, that's pretty much what was happening here.
Mm-hmm.
But we know that Joseph did not do that. He actually, when he woke up, he actually obeyed what the angel said.
Yes.
He took the angel at what God said. Mm-hmm. Can we take God at his word?
Mm-hmm.
You know, Matthew goes on to talk about Christ's birth, and Matthew talks about the three wise men, how they came bringing gifts, they came to worship the Messiah. If we keep reading Matthew, the second chapter, you'll find how Herod was trying to find the baby.
Yeah,
you know, he told the wise men, you know, go find this baby, you know, go find him so I may worship him. Mm-hmm. But you know, we know Herod was actually a liar and evil. He actually was planning on to kill the baby.
Yes, he was. And you know, even today, and this is a word for all of us, we need to be very careful that we don't let the enemy know what we are doing or what God is doing in our lives. We need to be very careful how we share things.
That's right.
You know, how we share things with others, because, you know, when God speaks to us, it's not meant for everybody else times. Amen.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Someone said the Lord gave me a dream. What does that say?
Renee said the Lord gave me a dream of wearing a white nursing dress and a cap before I accepted into nursing school to confirm that I was on the right track. He's faithful. Yes.
That's wonderful.
That's right.
Yes,
he will
he
confirm
is faithful.
It. That's right.
That's wonderful. I'm so glad you shared that with us, Prophetess Renee. Because many today don't believe that God does speak to us through dreams.
That's right.
And there's many people that don't.
That's right.
And I'm talking about people in the church.
Right.
You know, there's many that don't even believe that God does talk to us, you know.
That's
so
right.
That's wonderful. I'm
right.
glad you shared that.
And you were talking, Mom, about how to be careful who you share stuff with. Because some people act like they're for you. Mm-hmm. And they'll act very religious in how they want to, you know, bring you forward to your whatever you're going through or help you. And that's just like Herod. He was a liar. He was a deceiver. He had ultimate plans. He wanted to destroy.
Yeah.
And just like Prophet said, there's people out there trying to destroy your destiny, which
there
God
is.
Has in store
there
for you.
Is.
So be very careful who you tell what's going on in your life.
That's a word of wisdom we're giving you this morning.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah.
You know, but we read that the Lord didn't let that happen because God knows everything.
Yes,
God knew what was
does.
Taking place. God knew it was in his heart. And, you know, he sent an angel to warn Joseph to flee and go to Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
He also warned the wise men to not return back that way, to go a different way.
Yes.
So the Lord, if we're walking with the Lord will always warn us when danger's ahead. He will let us know when things aren't right.
He will. Mm-hmm.
In Matthew 2 and 14, it says, you know, he sent Joseph, he told him to go flee and go to Egypt so that the scriptures could be fulfilled.
Could be fulfilled, right.
And a part of that scripture is in Matthew 2 and 14. It says, out of Egypt I called my son.
Out of Egypt.
Hallelujah. Out of Egypt.
I love it. God, he takes care of his own. He really does.
That's
right. He does.
He knows what's going on. Like we said before many times, nothing catches him by surprise. God doesn't go on vacation. He knows everything that's going on. He knows everything that the devil has planned for you, to ambush you, for you not to reach your destiny. But God has the right plans, the right things that will keep you
on
track.
He says, I know the plans I have for you, plans to give you hope and plans to prosper you. I love that.
That's right.
Jeremiah, amen.
That's right. That's right.
I love it.
You know, now we're going to look at the, we will go and look at the book of Luke and see the birth through his eyes.
Yes, yes.
Luke actually starts off the book of Luke by talking about the coming birth of John the Baptist.
Yes, the forerunner.
The forerunner,
yes,
yep.
Yes, he was
that's
a forerunner.
Right.
Uh-huh.
And how an angel was sent to a virgin girl in Galilee.
Yes, yes.
And we're going to go ahead and read this. You can read along with us. And we're, like I said, we're going to talk in between the chapters. It's in Luke 1, 26 through 40. It says, in the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel.
Yes.
Now here we looked at Matthew, where he didn't talk about the angel being present with Mary, but we did see where the angel was sent through Joseph in a dream.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Here, God actually sent an angel physically to Mary.
That's right. Wow.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He knew that she probably needed to actually see an angel. Know that, okay, you're not dreaming. This is for real.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's awesome.
God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David.
Mm-hmm.
The virgin name was Mary.
Yes, yes.
The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you are highly favored. The
mm-hmm.
Lord is with you."
Mm-hmm.
You know, I know she's wondering, what does that mean?
Yes.
But even says that. Next one goes on to say, Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be.
Yes.
You know, I mean, she might have thought, well, gosh, am I in trouble? Did
mm-hmm.
I do something wrong?
Mm-hmm.
You know, but here she was about ready to become the most highly favored of all women of all time.
And Melissa, we need to take note of how active the angels were
mm-hmm.
in the birth of Jesus.
Yes.
I mean, all throughout, you know, Matthew's
mm-hmm.
View and also Mark's view, angels were,
mm-hmm.
the angels were very active.
Yes.
And I have said this before, and I just feel like I need to say it again. The angels are very active.
Yes.
Today, I believe this time of year,
mm-hmm.
angels are more active, and maybe I'm wrong.
I believe so.
You know, if I am, you know, that's fine too. But they are very active,
mm-hmm.
and we need to be aware, you know, that we could even entertain angels.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the Bible speaks about that, entertaining
sure.
angels unaware. You really don't know that they're an angel, but you need to be very attentive
mm-hmm.
to what the Spirit is saying, because this time of year, if what I'm trying to say is the angels are very active.
That's right.
Very active.
That's right. I know a lot of times in the house, I know there's angels all around
yes,
us. The Bible tells us
mm-hmm.
that we have our own angels are camped around us.
Mm-hmm.
They'll watch over us. And I always be doing something. I always can see something out of the corner of my eye.
Right.
I can always see
right.
some kind of shadow, but when I turn, I don't see it. But I don't feel afraid.
Mm-hmm.
I feel a good presence in the house. I know it's angels watching
yes,
over us.
Yes.
So
well,
you are right.
That's true. And
mm-hmm.
and one of the things that we need to do too is when we move into a new home or a new place,
mm-hmm.
You know, whether it's an apartment or a house or a mobile home or whatever,
mm-hmm.
we need to anoint that place
that's right.
with oil and dedicate it to the Lord.
That's right.
And when we anoint our home and dedicate it to the Lord, that gives the angels
mm-hmm.
a door to come in and
that's right.
And just minister. Of course, we know they do minister around us anyway. But we always believed in doing that, Melissa, anointing our house,
mm-hmm.
the doors, the windows, and, you know, and
that's, right.
that's the reason that we
mm-hmm.
feel such a presence
mm-hmm.
of God in this house is because we dedicated this home to
mm-hmm.
the Lord.
That's right.
You know, and the enemy cannot come in
mm-hmm.
here and touch us because
right.
the angels are encamped all around us. So I give God the glory for
that's
that.
Right. Yep, and we thank God for our house.
And you know, yes, we do. And you know, the thing of it is, we need to be aware of angels. The
mm-hmm.
Lord don't want us worshiping angels.
No.
We only worship God.
That's right.
But they are very real.
That's right.
They are very real. And God uses them on our behalf.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Help us. That's right.
Yes.
That's right. If you go on to read verse 29, it says, Mary was greatly troubled
mm-hmm.
at the words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be.
Yes.
But the angel said to her, because he already knew,
mm-hmm.
"Do not be afraid, Mary.
Mm-hmm.
You have found favor with God." I get goosebumps
mm-hmm.
when I feel,
mm-hmm.
when I read this. "You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David."
Yes.
"And he will reign over Jacob's descendant forever. His kingdom will never end."
Mm-hmm. And it's funny, Melissa, because you know I wrote the book on exposing the enemy,
mm-hmm.
and it was on fear, and that's exactly what God spoke to Joseph and to Mary
right.
when he sent the angel. "Fear
mm-hmm.
not."
That's right.
"Fear not." Fear is one of the number one spirits that harass God's people.
That's right. That's
Amen.
True.
Amen.
Yeah.
And so we, you know, God came to give us life and life more abundantly. Mm-hmm. And the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Mm-hmm. And one of the ways he does that is keeping God's people in fear. Mm-hmm. And we're not to fear, that's you right. know. And I thought that was just interesting mm-hmm. how he spoke to Mary and Joseph mm-hmm. and said, fear not. Because fear tried to mm-hmm. grab a hold of
that's
them.
That's right.
You know.
And the thing about it, even after that happened, you knew people were going to talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
People were going to say, oh, yeah, here they are trying to pull a fast one on us.
Mm-hmm.
You know. And I'm sure they talked, people whispered behind them, but they had, but right here, the angel said, don't worry about it. We're going to take care of it.
Yes.
You
yes.
are highly favored. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It says, and then Mary, it says in verse 34, how will this be? Mary asked the angel.
She's talking to the mm-hmm. angel.
Since I am a virgin.
Yeah.
Mm. How awesome is that? You know, here an angel is actually sitting here talking to her, having a conversation like we are right now.
Right.
Mm-hmm. It says, the angel answered, the Holy Spirit will come on to you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you.
Right.
So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God.
Son of God.
The Son of God. Mm-hmm. Wow. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age.
Mm-hmm.
And she who was said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month.
Yes.
For no word from God will ever fail.
Amen.
Wow. I love that.
I love that too.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes on to say, I am the Lord's servant. Mary answered, may your word to me be fulfilled. Then the angel left. So she said, okay,
yeah.
okay, you know
mm-hmm.
what?
Mm-hmm.
Lord, go ahead and use me.
Yes.
I'm here, Lord, use me.
Thank you, Father.
You know, we talk about Mary, and a lot of people, we know some religions actually worship Mary, which we don't worship Mary.
No.
We do thank God that she let, you know, the Lord use her. And yes, she is highly favored, and she's famous for all time. But you know what? She did pay a price for that.
Mm-hmm.
She paid a price. That wasn't an easy life back there. Like prophetess says, they could have both been killed. They could have
yeah.
been stoned to death. But you know, the Lord had his hand upon her.
And you know, we talked about sacrificing
mm-hmm.
last night.
That's right.
You know, and so she sacrificed a mm-hmm. lot of things.
Yeah.
To be able to be the mother of our Lord.
That's right.
I mean, that's powerful.
Yeah.
That's just powerful right there.
Yeah, she didn't even have a normal birth. She
mm-hmm.
was in the stables, in a manger.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
know, okay, Lord, here I'm supposed to be delivering the Son of God, and I'm not in a palace. But here I am, Lord, use me.
Yeah, and you know, and that's another thing that we need to ask ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Are we allowing the Lord to use us the
that's
way
right.
he wants to?
Mm-hmm.
You know, we know that he's not going to ask us to have another virgin birth
right,
because
exactly.
that was a one-time
mm-hmm.
thing there with the Lord Jesus Christ,
mm-hmm.
God in the flesh. It had to be that way. It could not come any other way.
That's right.
But, you know, God has a plan and a purpose for your life and my life this morning.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to ask ourselves, am I allowing God to use me the
that's
way
right.
he wants to use me? You know, Mary gave God permission.
That's right.
She did. She gave him permission.
Right.
She said, let it be unto me,
mm-hmm.
you know,
yeah,
as you
so.
Say.
That's right. And that's
thank
what
you,
God's
Lord.
Looking for. He's
mm-hmm.
looking for willing vessels.
Mm-hmm.
And I've had people say, well, you know, I wish God would just make us do it. But why? I don't even understand that. Because it's like, would you want to make somebody love you? Would you want to make your husband love you or your wife? You want them to love you
right.
because they love you.
Uh-huh.
And that's the same thing with Jesus.
It is.
He wants us to love
mm-hmm.
him because we love him.
Yes, yes.
If you go on to read in verse 39, it says, at that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judah.
Mm-hmm.
Where she entered Zachariah's house and greeted Elizabeth.
Yes.
You know, if we keep reading that chapter, you will see that Mary stayed with her, with Elizabeth, for 3 months.
Yes.
But when she got there, it talked about how the baby in Elizabeth's belly jumped for joy
mm-hmm.
at the mother of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Christ. They had a revelation that he was here.
Yes, yes.
You know, where others didn't know what was going on, they had a revelation that this is the mother of the Son of God.
And can you imagine Elizabeth and Mary spending
mm.
3 months
yeah.
together, you know, worshiping the
mm-hmm.
Lord together and just talking.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, with Elizabeth, it was a miracle, too.
That's right,
she was
exactly.
too old to have a child. You know, she was. Mm-hmm. She was too old to have a child, but here she was in her old age getting ready to give birth to a baby.
That's right.
And, of course, we know the story of Mary, what she went through. So they must have comforted one another, mm-hmm. Melissa.
That's right.
You know, been there for one another. Right. I think that's awesome.
That's right. They weren't sitting there gossiping. They're uh-huh. there worshiping the Lord, mm-hmm. thanking the Lord for how good he's been to
mm-hmm.
them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're involved in this whole, the birth of Christ. I mean,
yes.
just think how, what an honor that is.
And Elizabeth was going to give birth first.
To the front runner.
To the prophet John,
mm-hmm.
John the Baptist.
That's right.
And of course, we know that he was a forerunner of the Lord Jesus Christ.
That's right.
I mean, just the way the Lord mm-hmm. put that whole thing together.
Okay.
I mean, only God could do that.
That's right. And then the angel appeared to her husband.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, of course, he,
mm-hmm.
that, he had a different outcome than Mary and Joseph because he didn't believe they made him mute.
And he was a priest.
That's right.
Yes, he was a priest, but yet
yeah.
he doubted that it
That's
the
right.
Lord could do that.
That's right.
You know, but he got it together.
That's right. God gave him a chance.
He got it together. Amen.
He learned his lesson.
Look at how God
That's right.
uses people
yep.
or used people in the Bible
That's
that
right.
were not perfect.
That's right.
They were just like you and I.
That's right.
You know, and so don't try to tell God that he can't use you.
That's right.
Because he can use you.
That's
Hallelujah.
Right. He sure
All
can.
You have to do is be a willing vessel and
That's
he'll
right.
use you for his glory.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right. You know, as we go, and read the rest of Luke 2:4-20. We see the birth of Christ through Luke's eyes. And we're going to
yeah.
read this. You can
mm-hmm.
read it with us.
Yes.
It says, so Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David.
Yes, yes.
You know, we thought, well, how is he, you know, he's going to rule on David King's throne, but Joseph's not actually the father, but Mary actually is from the same lineage, just so you know. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
Right.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born.
Mm.
And she gave birth to him, to her firstborn, a son. It says, she wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord.
You know, wow.
God always makes a way,
mm-hmm.
doesn't he?
Yep.
Hallelujah.
Might not be how you thought it would be, but
he always makes a way. Yes, he does.
In verse 8, it says, and there were shepherds living in a field nearby.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we know Matthew didn't talk about no shepherds. He talked
mm-hmm.
about wise men. But here
right.
we see where Luke is talking
mm-hmm.
about
the shepherds. Yes.
And like I said, both accounts were true.
Yeah.
And there were shepherds living in a field nearby, keeping watch over their flock at night.
Yes.
Here we go again. Mm-hmm. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, I mm-hmm. do want to see an angel, but then I get scared. Like, I don't know, Lord, what if I die? I'm so scared. Because you read in the Bible over and over again, people are afraid. But we also read in the Bible over and over again, do not be afraid.
Yes, do not
They
be
are
afraid.
There to help us.
Yes.
But the angel said to them, do not be afraid.
Mm-hmm.
I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
I got a great message for you people.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You people are highly favored also. You don't even realize
yes,
that.
Yes, yes, amen.
It says, today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah. Wow.
Yes.
The Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find him. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and laying in a manger.
Wow.
It goes on to say, suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
yes.
Glory to God in the highest heaven. And on earth, peace to those of whom his favor rests.
Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine? Can you imagine that? You have an angel appear and he's telling you this great thing is happening. And all of a sudden, a multitude of angels appear.
Yes,
and
a multitude.
And here, apostle and prophets was talking about the angels they seen. How prophets saw angels in the house.
Mm-hmm.
And how then they saw one behind Pike's Peak.
Right.
I wonder how big these angels were.
Yeah.
You know, I wonder. It doesn't matter, but because they were delivering a message.
Mm-hmm.
But what an awesome sight that would have been to see.
Yes.
It goes on to say in 15, when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see the things that has happened, yes, which the Lord has told,
yes,
us about.
Mm-hmm.
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm sure they probably said, you know, we were out in the field and an angel appeared to us and said a child was born. You know,
wow.
And all who heard it were amazed. I would be, mm-hmm, I'm amazed,
oh,
now.
Yeah.
I'm amazed,
oh, yeah,
at now, and this, mm-hmm, is 2,000 years later. I'm amazed.
Well, they were looking and waiting and, mm-hmm, watching for the Messiah.
Yeah.
And so there was many that did believe that Jesus Christ was the Messiah,
mm-hmm,
you know.
That's right. And I believe that's why God showed up to these particular shepherds,
mm-hmm,
because they were watching, mm-hmm, they were looking.
Yes, they were.
It says, when they seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
Yes,
to
amazed,
them.
Amazed.
But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The shepherd returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things,
yes,
that they had heard and seen.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Which are just as they had been told.
Mm-hmm.
So here we see two different accounts of Jesus' birth. Like I said, Matthew and Luke, they both told the story. Neither contradicted the other.
No.
But they both saw something different.
Yes,
but they both did see the birth of Jesus,
yes,
Christ.
Yes, amen. Hallelujah.
You know, and that's like, me and Prophets was talking about this before we came on, and I was like, it's just kind of like how, you know, are we seeing correctly? Are we seeing what God is showing us? And Prophets could see it one way, I could see it another way.
Mm-hmm.
And we're talking about the Bible, how, you know, how Jesus was casting out demons, and the disciples come up to the Lord. There's some people over there that are casting out demons in your,
mm-hmm,
name, and we told them to stop.
Uh-huh.
And Jesus said, don't do that.
No.
Don't do that. They, mm-hmm, whoever's doing that is for us, not against,
yeah,
us.
That's true.
Let them be.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to have that same attitude. People not be the same as us or talk like us, but as long as they're believing in the Lord Jesus Christ, that he is the Savior, and they've had, you know, asked him to come into our life, and they, you know, let's leave them alone.
Yes.
Let's leave them alone and pray for them.
Uh-huh.
You know, we're not all the same, and that's one thing that's great about God, is that he did not make us all the same.
Yeah, it's true.
He did not make
us
all the same.
Well, Melissa, that's one of the reasons that we have so many different churches.
Mm-hmm.
And I, you know, God wants us to know the truth. He says the truth is what's going to set us free.
That's right.
But, you know, there's some, okay, we are part of a prophetic movement.
That's right.
You know, apostolic and prophetic movement.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have other churches like the faith movement.
Mm-hmm.
They talk more about faith, you know. You have people like Apostle and I. We talk a lot about miracles, signs,
mm-hmm,
wonders, and miracles. You know, and then we have some of our brothers and sisters that don't even believe that God,
mm-hmm,
performs miracles today.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing of it is, and this is what we say, and this is where we come from, if we all believe in the shed blood of the Lord Jesus,
that's right,
Christ, that he died on the cross for our sins, we can get along.
Mm-hmm.
We
that's
can.
Right.
We might not believe just like each other believes, but we can, you know, fellowship on that one thing,
mm-hmm,
Melissa.
That's right.
You know, and try to enlighten one another into more truth.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yes, but, you know, the different denominations saw even the Gospels differently.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
that's
they
true.
Did. And so, but anyhow, God is a good God.
Well, that's true.
He is a good God.
And, you know, in Matthew and Luke, people probably might have try to pit them together. Oh, he saw it this way, and he saw,
mm-hmm,
it this way, or he was,
mm-hmm,
right, and he was wrong, just like they tried in the Bible. But neither one of them wrong. Both of them told the story a different way, but they both pointed it to Jesus' birth. Mm-hmm. And that's what we're saying. You know, how do you see? Are you seeing correctly? Mm-hmm. Is it pointing towards Jesus?
Yes.
And that's
yes.
what we're talking about this morning. We're talking about his birth, but how are we pointing others to Jesus?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's just like preaching the gospel or ministering in the gifts.
That's right.
You know, we need to make sure that we're pointing people to Jesus.
That's right.
You know, we're pointing them to God, the one true God that we serve.
That's right.
You know, not trying to get them to look at us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that we're some big, great thing because we're nothing without Jesus Christ.
Right.
Amen. So we need to keep our eyes focused on him and try to bring others to him, you know, to
That's
him.
Right.
That's right.
That's right. Because, you know, you could bring others your way and I could bring others my way. When we're saying, you know, through Jesus Christ, I'm saying that. But, you know, I might have a different speech to people where you have a different speech. I know how to reach people different my age, you have your age,
yes.
or what, and that's what we're just saying. You know, we all have our own way of pointing others to Jesus, but the goal is to all point everybody to Jesus.
Yes, he is,
you know?
The way, the truth, and the life. That's just who he is.
That's almost true. Like the different versions of the Bible, how Pastor Edwards talked about the Message. I do love the Message because
it does
have our language of today. You know, hey, don't be partying, don't be drunk, and it's really breaks it down to today. And that's what kind of like what we're saying also. There's different versions of the Bible, but it's all basic. They're all the same. It's all talking about the birth, the death, the resurrection, talking about the Old Testament. It's all the same, but it's just a different version of how somebody tells it.
Yeah.
So that is actually, you know, the message for
and
today.
But there is some versions that leave the blood of Jesus out.
That
we
is
don't
true.
We don't want to get caught up in that either.
Right.
You know, we have to make sure that, you know, the church that we go to or the Bible that we read, you know, is a true version of the Word of God.
That's right.
And here in our home, we have many, many, many different versions of the Bible. When I'm writing a book, I use many different versions of the Bible to end up doing my research, what this one said, what that one said. Some brings a different light to that same scripture. You know, and you can really learn by that. You really, really can.
That's right.
But we serve an awesome God.
That's
and
right.
if we're faithful to the Lord, and if we're walking in the Spirit, we will not be deceived.
That's right.
We won't be deceived.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right, because God will give us that little tug. Okay, something's not right here, you know. Yes. So it's very important to walk in the Spirit.
Yes, hallelujah.
Keep that prayer life going.
Yes. Staying close to the Lord.
Reading the Word. Knowing what the Word says.
Uh-huh.
Getting revelation of the Word.
And one of the things that I'm doing, and I've been doing now for a few years, is reading the book of Luke. And if you read the book of Luke starting the first day of December, you will finish up reading the whole chapter on the 24th of December on Christmas Eve. And there's so much in that book. There's only what, 24 chapters, but so much in that book. And it's about the Lord Jesus Christ and his birth. And it's just, I love it, which I love the Bible, period. But I do love reading the book of Luke at this time of year.
That's right.
And we just want to say to you today that all those that are watching or will watch later on, you know, even though we do have a Christmas tree in our home, and even though we, you know, we have a big dinner, the family comes and we all get together and exchange gifts and things like that, everything that we do is surrounded around
That's
the birth
right.
of the Lord.
That's right.
The reason we, you know, we never taught our children that there was a Santa and he was going to come down the chimney and bring them toys. We taught our children about the Lord Jesus Christ, that we're celebrating the birth of Jesus. And if you get any toys, it will be because God blessed your parents and they were able to buy you something. And so, you know, and I have said this before, you know, it didn't ruin you guys, did it, Melissa? As a matter of fact, now that you're older, you laugh and talk about, do you remember this? Do you remember that? Do you remember when you said this? Or, Dad, do you remember that? And and you guys fall back on what you were taught
That's
way
right.
back then.
It's in our spirit.
And you know that, yes.
We were raised upright.
Uh-huh.
We're raised with the Word in our spirit. In our, you know, we try to run from it, but God won't let you run from it. You know, that's another good thing you know, what does the Bible say? Train up a child the way he should go. When he's, mm-hmm. when he's old, he won't depart. Because he might depart. And he might depart during his life, but they said when he's old, he will not depart.
I love that.
So get that. You know, it doesn't mm-hmm. say they won't ever, but it says when they're old, they won't. Mm-hmm. They'll come back. That's what it's saying.
Yes,
he'll come back.
Exactly.
God will draw them back. God will be
exactly.
faithful to the parents that mm-hmm. that fed you that word all your life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I thank God for that, because you can't run fast enough. You can't run anywhere where he's not there.
Yeah.
He will always constantly draw you. You know, so I just thank God this morning.
Pastor Edward came over Monday night for dinner, mm-hmm. and we were sitting around the table talking about the Lord, and I thought, here I am. I'm sitting here mm-hmm. at the table and with my husband and two of my children, and our conversation mm-hmm. is about the Lord. That's what
right.
we talk about.
That's right.
We talk about the Lord. And we remember God said this or God did that,
mm-hmm.
and you know, it's just, that's what's important.
Mm-hmm.
That's the thing. That's what's
right.
important. You know, yes, it's nice to have a nice home. It's nice to have a nice car. It's nice for God to bless us.
That's
but
right.
the most important thing is God, then the Word of God.
That's right.
And we thank God that we have the Word, and we
That's
were
right.
able to impart the Word into
yes.
our children, and we're now imparting mm-hmm. the Word into our spiritual children.
That's right.
And Melissa, life is good, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, life
God
is
has
great.
Brought us
yeah.
through so much. And God is so faithful.
Mm-hmm.
He is so faithful. So we just want to say to you this morning, you know, enjoy this time
That's
of
right.
year. Enjoy it with your family. And
That's
know
right.
that God loves you.
That's
and,
right.
But remember, the most important thing is that we are celebrating the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ. And you might say, well, prophetess, we really don't know when he was born. Well, we don't.
Mm-mm.
We don't know the exact day. But we do know that he was.
That's right.
And he came to save us from our sins.
That's right.
And so we honor his birth because
uh-huh.
of that. Because without him, we would be lost.
That's right.
You know, without him, we would be lost.
That's
Isn't that right.
right,
Melissa?
That's right. That's right.
Yes.
Yep, he paid that price for all of us
mm-hmm.
that we might be saved, even while we were yet sinners. That's
And I thank the Lord for Mary and Joseph.
That's right. Exactly.
You know, and how they... were obedient to what
mm-hmm.
God wanted to do in their life and use them for his glory.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the way I want to be.
Mm-hmm.
I want God to use me
mm-hmm.
for his glory.
That's right.
And I do want to share my new book I did last night. It still says not for resale on this one, but it is for
proof.
Sale
yeah.
today.
That's right.
You can order it today from Amazon, or if you'd rather get a signed copy, you can email me at booksbylinda2@gmail.com
mm-hmm.
and I will get you a signed copy. But it's about the last revival
mm-hmm.
and it's the supernatural move of God.
Mm-hmm.
And then the Lord said, let the greater works people arise. And this is what is happening now.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, this is what's happening in the world. We're getting ready to see the last
mm-hmm.
revival. You know, many of us have prayed and prayed and prayed for revival. But God is raising up a people, the greater works people.
Jesus.
And then they're going to be the ones that God sends out and brings in the end time harvest.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to be one of those. Don't you, Melissa?
Yeah.
We are one of
yeah.
those already. You know,
yeah.
God is moving by his Spirit.
Yeah, I was just thinking when you're saying that about how, you know, how it was foretold for a long time about a virgin and the birth.
Uh-huh.
And here is Mary and Joseph is actually... vessels that God, you know, they're famous.
Was using for God's
yeah.
glory.
And like
mm-hmm.
you said, we're the same right now. We're
uh-huh.
we're going to be famous because what we're letting the Lord do through us.
Yes.
I'm
yes.
not saying we'll be some great name. I'm just saying because what we do is value.
Mm-hmm.
We hold value with the kingdom of God.
Uh-huh.
We let the Lord use us how he wants to. We're just like Mary and Joseph. God use us and God will.
Yeah.
For his glory.
We are called to be the greater works
That's
people
right.
that Jesus
That's
talked about.
We're supposed to do more works than
yes.
Jesus. Think
Jesus,
about that.
He prophesied
yeah.
that. That's what this book is about.
That's right.
And about getting us prepared for the end time
That's
harvest.
Right. That's
and
right.
we're going to see signs, wonders, and miracles like we've never seen
mm-hmm.
before.
That's right.
I mean,
I'm like
Jesus
yeah.
when he walked the earth and all the things that he did. His church, his body will be doing
mm-hmm.
more than he did. Think about that.
Oh, yeah.
You know, not for us to. I'm sorry, my phone. I thought I had my phone shut off. Not for us to bring glory to ourselves,
right.
but
Lord.
To bring glory
right.
to Him.
That's right.
Yes, to bring glory to Him. Amen.
That's right. I remember when I first came out to God, and you know, you're just so full of zeal. You just, You just want to save everyone. And I just didn't understand, because I knew in the Bible where it said we will do greater works. And mm-hmm. I believe, like you do, prophetess, mm-hmm. I believe we will raise the dead, set the captive free.
Yes, I believe,
but I believe it's the Spirit in us, not me actually mm-hmm. doing it. And I just didn't understand why I did not see that.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't. Mm-hmm. I didn't understand why the church is not doing that.
Right. Well, I believe that we're coming into it's not in the church building either.
That's right.
You know, yes, we are going to see it in the church,
mm-hmm.
but you'll be on the job
mm-hmm.
and someone fall over with a heart attack and
that's
die.
Right.
And you just walk over and lay your hands
that's
on
right.
them and raise them up.
Mm-hmm.
God, Jesus would, if
that's
he was
right.
here, that's exactly what mm-hmm. he would do. You know, he would walk in the hospitals
mm-hmm.
for those that are on these ventilators and all the things that we see and hear tell of
that's
today.
Right.
And all he would do is speak the word, and they would be healed in Jesus' name.
That's right. God.
And so he's training mm-hmm. and equipping the church to do these things.
That's right. Because it wasn't in the synagogue that he was doing these miracles.
Yeah.
It was actually out in the public
mm-hmm.
that he was doing these miracles. And you're so right,
that's
prophetess.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And that's what we're called to do.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That's awesome.
God bless you, Brother Gill.
Yes.
We're glad you watched this morning.
Yes.
Maybe one day we'll get to meet in person. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Well,
thank you, Father. I believe that's it,
yeah.
Melissa. Just keep your eyes on the
that's
Lord.
Right.
Continue to worship him and praise him.
That's right.
And stay focused
that's
on
right.
him.
Enjoy your family,
yes,
too.
Enjoy your family.
But I'm going to
yes.
go ahead and pray. Lord, we thank you for this morning. Lord, we thank you for those that are on here this morning with us, listening to your word.
Mm-hmm.
We ask you, Lord, to bless them. We ask pray for the ones that are going to be on here later on, Lord, bless them and keep them, Lord.
Yes,
Lord,
Jesus.
Let them have that peace that passeth all understanding this
thank
season.
You,
let them
Lord.
Have that joy, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Let them have this time, Lord, to soak in your presence and to be with their family, Lord, and just enjoy the season, Lord,
yes.
that you've led us, that we're allowed to be here this time,
thank
Lord.
You, Lord.
There's a lot that didn't make it to this next Christmas, but Lord, we thank you for letting
mm-hmm.
us be here, Lord.
Mm-hmm.
We pray for those that need healing in the body, Lord, healing in the mind, Lord, those that need financial assistance, Lord. We ask you, Lord, to meet each need,
yes,
Lord, as
Jesus,
we go today, Lord.
By your
we
spirit,
ask you to keep
Lord.
Your hand upon each one as we all about on these crazy highways and byways, Lord. Put your angels around us, Lord. And we ask you, Lord, just to keep each one till we meet again in your precious name. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Well, God bless you. And Pastor Edward
Ever.
Will be ministering Sunday. And Apostle and I will be back next Wednesday night. And Melissa and me will be back next Thursday.
That's right.
So continue to serve the Lord and enjoy your family, like Melissa said.
Mm-hmm.
And we will see you soon.
All right. God bless you.
God bless you.